Hi, everybody. This is another session with our upcoming Senator Leonard Ongadi. And he's standing for Vihiga County. And one of the things I can tell you, I am so excited about this guy. I think this is the guy we need to get in 2022. He needs to be Senator for Vihiga County. Why? The reason being, at least we are not going to those days of handouts. We want to move to really moving Vihiga County to be an information technology hub. Can you imagine how that would be if we got all our people really in tuned into the 21st century? That means they are able to use technology, and using the office really bring technology in Vihiga County. Mr. Ongadi, Senator Ongadi, Honorable Ongadi, can you tell us more about your vision on information technology in Vihiga County?
Thank you so much, Judy. My name, viewers, is Leonard Ongadi. I am standing for the elections of a senator in Vihiga County. And I am so glad that my experiences will come and enrich the lives of the people of Vihiga. As we may know right now, information technology is revolutionizing everything we are doing. Information technology is becoming the biggest employer and the biggest millionaire maker. If you are keen, you will see how people are coming up with apps, and those apps are employing people, and those apps are getting people richer and richer. So one of the things in life that people would do, I mean, what rich people do is they create an arm for passive income. Passive income in the sense that your money comes in anytime without your active participation, and irrespective of whether you are sleeping or working. So, for instance, if you look at the owner of Microsoft, Mr. Bill Gates, his money is coming in even if he dies right now. He will still be rich. You look at the owner of the founder of Facebook, the money is coming in day and night, irrespective of where he is. He could be on vacation, but money is coming in. Why? Because information technology is bringing people on the same level, and it is collapsing all those structures we had before. And that is why you could have a Twitter and talk to your president directly. Not like before, where you would look for protocol, you go to State House, you look for someone who knows someone who knows someone who knows the president. Right now, the president has a Twitter account, and if you want to tell him something, you can tell him straight away. So this is opening so many supernatural doors that we were not privy of before. In my plans to work for the people of Vihiga, I have prioritized a lot of programs, but one of the programs is information technology. And I work here with the US government, and I have seen how IT is transforming lives. For instance, where I work, we have used a program called Workforce, where we have put more than 5,000 Americans on the job market, on online job market. So some of them are teachers, some of them work from home, some of them. So this is something that is doable, is something workable, is something that has been tested elsewhere, and it's something that can come and work for the people of Vihiga. I would want to just brush up with, because of time and because of we have so many other programs that will come and be talking to you guys. But this important one is the information technology, which I would want us to brush over and just see how we can create almost over 10,000 jobs for our young people. So one of them is,
maybe start with, what is the vision? What's the vision of Vihiga? What vision do you have?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Judy. So my vision for the people of Vihiga, especially on this IT program, is to facilitate an enabling environment that will birth an explosion of information technology related opportunities that will bring transformational change to the lives of the great people of Vihiga. So information technology can do so many other things, but I would want us to just look at a few of them. So one is, the baseline of information technology is having the computer literacy. So until our people have computer literacy, they cannot reap the benefits of information technology. So one is, the first and most important one is we will have classes. So these classes, we will provide classes at depending on the number of people. We will be providing free classes for the people so that our people who have come from, our children who have come from high school, our children who have come from primary schools, or the those are still in schools, can learn computer classes. They will know how to operate a computer. In these computer classes, we will have courses on, for instance, how to troubleshoot problems, how to install software, how to know if a software is wrong, and how to mitigate when a problem arises. The second one is, because of that, we are looking at an improved computer literacy in the community, where we will have even Mama Mboga having us can send an email, can put her business on online, and can be communicating with the people within the county. For instance, Mama Mboga selling kunde in Majengo Market does not have necessarily to move to come to Majengo. They can actually be where they are and send parcels or send people to come and take the mboga, but they will have the, we are coming to the concept of how that will happen online. You see, so right now, if you are keen, you realize that many people are coming online. Mitumba people are coming online. You don't have to move from market to market selling your clothes if you're selling Mitumba. So what you do is you just put yourself on the online and advertise your products. So we will come to the online concept later on, but that is as a result of improved computer literacy in the community. Number two, thank you. So number two, we will also create, because of the computer literacy embedded in the community, we will have people coming in, setting up small cyber cafe businesses. So you can have your five or three computers where someone can come in and check their email and go. For instance, you can have a cyber cafe where you can go and do some photocopy. You can have a cyber cafe where you can come in and communicate with someone far off. Because of information technology, information technology has shrunk the distance between people. For instance, I'm in America. I am in Washington DC, and Judy is in California, which is miles apart, like from between Kenya and Nigeria. But we can communicate, and we are communicating real time. So that's the importance of information technology. The other issue, the other advantage of that is, after we do this, we will have a program where we will support people to start small scale photocopy businesses. So you can come and have a photocopy. We know government needs a lot of documents. You go to you want to apply for a birth certificate in Vihiga, in Mbale, and you find that, oh, you don't have a photocopy document. So these are the documents, the businesses we will support, so that you will help people to reproduce what they have, and also, for instance, it also helps someone to save a document for future use. For instance, you can photocopy and you can scan your document to an email, so that in case your birth certificate gets lost, in case your KCPE, KCAC certificate gets lost, you just go to your email and print. We this program will also create so many other opportunities. For instance, we will have people who will just be typesetting. Typesetting is, we have a company which you come in, you say what you want, they do the typesetting. If it is a billboard, they will do for you, they do, you know. And then if it is something you want to communicate with people, so we will have typists and typesetting services. And these are the opportunities we will be supporting. We are looking at in the future where people, our graduates or people who will pass through this program, will be a benefit to the community in one way or another. Also, like I had said before, businesses are increasingly being put on the international market, and the international market does not necessarily have to make you travel from Kenya to come to Australia or to America or to UK physically. No, you can have a website, and having this website, then you advertise your products on this website. So they will, in the future, we are foreseeing an explosion of website developers, because we will have everybody wanting to be on the website. For instance, we have so many schools, primary and secondary, and some universities and colleges in Vihiga. So, yes. And we have parents from all over the country. So we can't, for instance, if something happens, you don't have to contact a parent. I mean, it will be tedious. So what we are looking for is, we want to create an opportunity like for every school to have a website administrator. For instance, buses, who take care of the finance of the school. We also foreseeing a situation where we will have web administrators and webmasters in every school, so that when something happens in school or there is a meeting, that communication is put on the website, and every parent can go and access the website. You know, then it becomes easier to admin, to even check your students' results, instead of waiting for your daughter or son to come with a report card that they have cooked, or coming with a fee structure that they have typed somewhere and cooked. You can actually just go to the website and say, hey, okay, form one, we are paying this amount. Form two, this is the amount. So it becomes easier to manage information. So we are looking at a situation where, as we move towards information technology, we also want to help future parents, so that those parents can manage information easily. We have a parent who has children in 5 secondary schools. So for instance, this parent, it will be very hard for them to catch up with information from every school. So what happens is, they'll just be going to school, they do what? They just click, this is the information that is needed. If there is a disciplinary issue, parents will have an email that will be attached. I mean, the schools will have email addresses. So when a disciplinary action is needed, for instance, I'm just giving an example, then you don't need to have a kid to go and buy a parent out there to come and stand for them, like it has been happening previously. You just need to go to the school, to the school website. You don't have to travel from Mombasa to Vokoli Girls to get a simple piece of information. What you need is just to access the website, and the information about your student is there, because every student has an admission number.
Correct.
So we are looking at an explosion of opportunities in website development and website administration. We are also looking at coding, the possibility of coding. We have students who we want to have basic knowledge of coding and software engineering. So for instance, we have JavaScript, we have Java, we have PHP, C++, we have so many other languages. But now, when we have a population of young people who start programming at an early age, for instance, in primary school, for instance, it could be one of the voluntary courses, like in primary school, like in high school or lowers, then we are creating a population that is informed, a population that is a quality population that will know what to do with computers. You see, for instance, I learned programming at a very late age. I used to go to offices and I would see how people were operating their computers, and I was like, oh my goodness, this is something so nice. The first time I operated a computer is when I had joined my university, and I mean that's the first time I touched a mouse, and I was like, I didn't even know pads. So this is the information I would want us to relay to our young people, so that as they grow up, they can have basic knowledge on coding, on software, and technical engineering. There is an explosion of mobile apps. Yes. People make mobile apps, and when they make mobile apps, they sell the mobile apps, and some people just, you know, it has made millionaires. One of the mobile apps, for instance, is Facebook. So you have a mobile app, and this mobile app can actually create employment for so many other people. Look at the way if you read the history of Facebook. Facebook started as a game, you know, for within a campus, a university campus. Then it extended to a bigger locality. Then before it even became an international concept. So mobile apps are creating a lot of millionaires. You can create a mobile app for health, for instance. You can create a mobile app for a car, so that we have mobile apps that can tell you when your car needs service, if your car is faulty, where exactly, so that if you are a layman like me in mechanical engineering, like in with your car, you can actually know. Like, for instance, I have an app that tells me when I need to go for service, when I need, when there is a puncture in one of my wheels, when something is wrong, anything is wrong, that app tells me, you know, it informs me. So this is what I would want us to bring to Vihiga, and our program will come and help people, especially our idle computer, computer and IT graduates, to now advance to this, because they already have the basic information on computers. So mobile apps are very good income. For instance, look at the person who started this Safaricom M-Pesa. You know, that's an app. That's an app, yeah. So we want to bring people to an idea, to have an idea. Like, I could have something that will help me to do something, but I don't have to be there physically. I can use an app. Right now, Judy, you realize you can actually close your door in California while you are in Kenya, right? So yes. You are in Kenya, you are in Nairobi, you are looking at your house, you are looking at every room, you are looking if there's an intruder, you know, and if there's an intruder, before they even know, you've already called 911 and he's arrested. Why? Because that app, the app will help you. So we are looking at creating a huge creative pool of our young people in Vihiga to know how to create apps and how to help the world become a better place to live in. Thank you for that. So then we have another opportunity for our programs will be only online writing. You realize newspapers nowadays, for instance, Standard would need you to go to Nairobi to be Nairobi newsroom for you to edit their news and for you to lead and to guide and to do everything. With IT, you don't have to go to Nairobi if you're in Vihiga and you're employed by NTV. All you have to do is you can edit your newspaper, you can edit magazines, you can actually still become an editor from the comfort of your house. You don't have to move, you see. So this is what we are doing. We have blogs, we have people who we have students, in international students, who want to have professional paper write-ups. You can write for them. while from home. But now this is one of the programs we are thinking it will create employment for our people. You don't have to work from 8 to 5 job, an 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. job. You can actually work from the comfort of your house, and you don't even have to work hard. You can work smart. You can put in like 4 hours that are very intensive, and the rest of the 18 hours you are free. You don't have to work, you don't have to do so much and earn less. So that is the benefit of IT. Another thing is on social media, I have seen, yes, our young people are on social media, but they are on social media for wrong reasons. I would say, forgive me if one of my viewers will be offended. Why? Because you are on social media poking other people, looking for gossip, and some people are just poisonous to just poison the minds of others on social media. Social media can actually help young people become employed. We have seen social media influencers, you see. We have seen people who are on Facebook, but they are doing much, much greater. There's no problem having a Facebook account. There's no problem having an IG account, a Twitter account. But how is it helping you, you know, achieve your goal instead of it coming and not helping you a lot? You know, I have young people who are always on Facebook. I am. Sometimes I look on Facebook. Young people are always on Facebook. I am on WhatsApp. My young people are on WhatsApp. But what are they doing on WhatsApp? They're just there to get, to get information that is not helpful. You know, nobody, and helpful information cannot be found just simple like that. You have to dig deeper for information. You have to, if you want to do farming, how can you be an ineffective farmer? You see, that is the power of social media. What else? The other opportunity that we want to create for our young people is become computer researchers. You don't have to be employed in Nairobi. You don't have to go to Nairobi, pay someone rent, and pay someone's car because you'll be using matatus in the morning and the evening. You don't have to, you don't have to do all those things. You can actually stay home and work from home and do computer research for international organizations, for instance. You can have an organization like, Unilever. They want to know how Vihiga people behave because of big data, companies are having a challenge to sieve through the big data to know how a particular people in a particular place behave. So if, for instance, you can be in Vihiga and you are a researcher for Unilever, you are a researcher for Bidco, then you can actually inform Bidco and tell Bidco, hey, this is how we behave. This is our culture. If you want to come like this, if you want to come to this market, you have to package yourself like this, because companies, people are different and people are unique. The way a company would go to Amijikenda in Mombasa is not the same way they would come to Vihiga. First, because of cultural differences, tribal differences, and because of geographical differences. Mombasa is always hot. Vihiga is sometimes cold, you see. So this is one of the opportunities. The other opportunity, and it is a huge, huge opportunity that I had touched on before, is the online teaching opportunity, teaching jobs. So we have, for instance, in where I work, my program has put more than 5,000 people on online teaching jobs. We have, initially, we used to have a challenge, or a communication challenge. So people, for instance, you can have a class, you can have a virtual class, and you are teaching Chinese. You are teaching Chinese how to cook, for instance, how to cook githeri. You can teach Chinese children on how to speak Swahili. You can teach them English because they don't learn English. You can teach French kids on how to speak Swahili too. So we have an explosion of opportunities in virtual, when it comes to virtual classes. And these virtual classes are becoming a hit in my locality alone here in the US, and as I said, I mean, we have more than 5,000, in a program one of the programs that I head that is called Workforce Program. So these young people already have jobs. And look at it this way, my fellow vegan. If you have a job, if you have an online job, you are teaching like 10 kids. They could be, but they are far away from you. They could be Chinese, they could be Singaporeans, they could be British, they could be French. And for instance, one parent is paying like $10. You are getting $10 an hour, for instance. That is a cool 1,000 an hour. You only need to work like for 3 hours a day and you are good, because if you have 3,000 today, tomorrow you have how much will you have for the month? You'll have 90,000. And this is an opportunity that I am very keen on bringing back home, because wow. because we have children who can be taught English. We have Chinese children, we have Japanese, we have Korean, we have Rwandese. Like anything you would want to teach, if you want to teach dancing, cultural, I also lead a cultural project, program in where I work. You can show people how to dance. You can present a song, and you can teach kids and they will learn. And you're earning your money. Honest money without having to travel. So you can do that in a virtual class. So when it comes to virtual classrooms and virtual offices, I have a concept, and the concept we have is, in our IT program, we will have virtual offices and virtual classrooms. So, for instance, if let's say you live in Chamahoho, we will have a virtual office in Chamahoho, a small virtual classroom and a virtual office. So all you have to do is present yourself. Everything will be there. We will talk to our sponsors. We'll talk to Google. We will talk to Microsoft. They will come with all their programs and everything. All you have to do is just be in a class and everybody else watches. You will be in that class by yourself because you won't see anybody, but you are teaching millions of people out there. Now, with the advent of COVID, the need and the demand for online classes and the virtual offices has exploded. You don't need to go to Nairobi or Kisumu to work. If you have to, what you do is you'll come to our office. We will give you a space, and this space you'll be working from. You can work from there. If you have mail, if you have letters, we will give you everything. So what you do is just present yourself. And when you have visitors, your visitors will come to your virtual office.
Wow.
So
that is amazing. That is so amazing. I mean, it's just limitless.
Yes, and that's the word. It's limitless, yes. Mm-hmm.
And then you have the online data analysis opportunities.
Yes. I was going to that. So yeah. And then we have opportunities of online data analysis. So because of huge data, big data that has been accumulated over ages and nothing has been done on it, we have a huge demand for data scientists and data analysts. For instance, look at Safaricom. Safaricom has millions of numbers, millions of subscribers, and how would Safaricom know how people in Mombasa behave? They need someone to look through the data, to analyze the data, and put aside data that is not important, and say, okay, this is the data. It is just like a farmer who goes to harvest honey. There is the wax that you put aside. You see, it is important. The wax is important, but the wax, you don't need the wax, for instance, to make honey. You know, you only need to harvest the honey. You can do something else with the wax. But we, as we speak of the honey, you can package it. So that is what data analysts do and data scientists do. You get big, huge, huge data. Supporters, we will have stakeholders, we will have donors, we will have people who will come to, for instance, we will have software engineers that have already produced this these softwares. So the software that we'll use, it is not something that you're not going to look into trillions of data by eye. No, you're just going to have a computer and you feed that information in the computer and you make graphs and you make the information presentable. Mm-hmm. So that is an explosion of online data analysts and scientists. Then we come to another opportunity that we can come to is online content creation. We can have comedians, we can have artists, we can have actors, singers, songwriters, event writers, and event managers, and so many other people who will use the services of content writers. Now, you don't have to go to Kenya National Theatre to get there and sit there to get some people who you will work with or you will work for. No, you just contact a few actors and you have a niche of actors, for instance, and you can be writing for them the contents from the comfort of your home. So one of the important things about information technology is the importance of just doing the benefit of doing of working from the comfort of your zone. You don't have to go to some place to work. You can actually work from your bedroom. You can work from your sitting room. You can actually work while you're cooking in the kitchen. So that's the importance of IT. Then we also have trainers. We have trainers. For instance, someone who trains. You are a trainer. You are looking for opportunities to train employees, for instance, to train children. You will not be going to Mombasa to train people. Then next week you are in Nakuru training people. Then no, you can actually have a virtual classroom. You can have a virtual office from where you can actually teach people, and people will be following what you're saying, and people will get your training, and you will interact with your people. You don't have like unlike before where you would go to a training physically to train people. This you can do from the comfort of your zone. Another thing is, as a trainer, you can actually write, you can actually have your material online so that if I want to know how to cook ugali, I will have to pay some money. Like if, for those who are in the know, like what Udemy does. So you will have, for instance, you can have, we will have people who have training materials. And if you want to know, for instance, how to do something, if you want to know how to troubleshoot a computer, if you want to know how to do something, just anything you can do on, you can learn. What you have to do is just have your material there. Then somebody will come and access your material, but they pay before accessing and the money goes straight to you. It goes straight to your M-Pesa. It goes straight to your bank account. It goes straight to your to your credit card or to your debit card. You see, so that is what we are working on. Then there is the need for graphic designers. Graphic designers are people who make things look presentable physically. You know, like they want to make sure if you have a billboard, you go to them. You have this, you got. So online graphic designers, you will not have also to go look for business in every town. You can actually have your good. You can have your good work. Exposed on the website, on your website, and people will be coming to look at the work and just contacting you. One of these is Facebook, which is constantly looking for graphic designers because of marketing and because of advertising. Facebook is looking for contractors. You don't have to work for Facebook. You go tell Facebook, hey, I am very good in graphic design, and this is what I can produce for you. But now you will be paying me for everything I do for you. So that is how people are earning. We have people who, young people who are doing exploits with the internet and on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, on every platform, online platform that you can think of. Then the other one is computer technician. In this program, we will also have classes for people who want to advance and to know how to operate a laptop or a computer. If there is a problem, how would you be able to troubleshoot your problem? You don't have to take your laptop to some fake fundi who will stay with it for ages. Yet the problem may be something you would have solved. Maybe you would have known, oh, it is this key that is wrong, it is this software that is wrong, it is this something that is wrong, and that is what we want to teach our people. We come to business intelligence. Our IT program is heavily aimed at helping create small-scale businesses in Vihiga County. And these small-scale businesses, we'll need business analysts, business intelligence people. So you are an intelligence officer. You know how you will be contacted by these small scale businesses. The backbone of every economy, of any economy in the world, even here in America, and I know Judy, you can affirm to this, is small businesses.
Correct.
Small businesses are creating a huge explosion of opportunities, because if you have a business, you will employ your sister, you will employ your neighbor, you will have a driver, then by having a business itself, you have stopped becoming a dependent on the society, on the community. So you're doing something positive with your business. Then you will have suppliers. If you are selling mandazis, you will have somebody who is bringing their mandazis. That person bringing you the mandazis has employed people who are making those mandazis. Then when you have these mandazis, you are going to supply them to hotels. And those hotels will also create employment opportunities. Then these people who have hotels, maybe they have a chain of hotels. So there is the importance of having small businesses. We don't call them small scale anymore, because they are small businesses. So small businesses are a huge explosion for opportunities, and this will create an opportunity for us. And now we'll have business analysts and business intelligent specialists who will be advising those businesses. Then also, of course, we have, because of the internet working of computers, we will have websites, we will have people IP addresses, are getting attached to your website, or you may also have a website attached to as an IP address to another website. So we will also have information technology, network administrators. We will have database administrators. We will have so many other people. We'll have software, like I said, software developers. And then because of that, there will also be a challenge for the security of that information. So then we will create opportunities. We will create opportunities for information security specialists who will now help to keep that information secure and to keep the data and information secure. We've talked about virtual offices, where you can have an office and it's virtual. You only come. All we will need is for you to come. We will have a schedule. For instance, we say, Mbone, you have 7 to 8 to 9. You can do your stuff there. Then we have Evelyn, we have you from 9 to 11. Then Jen, we have you from 11 to 12. Then James, we have you from 12 to 3, like that. So all you have to do is just come at your time schedule, do whatever you want to do. If you want to teach, if you want to work, if you want to train in that virtual office, which we will make sure we have them in every sub-county. We'll have virtual offices in every sub-county to help our people create opportunities for jobs. Lastly, our program will create a deluge of small businesses. We are going to increase revenue for Vihiga County. We will have people paying taxes. We will have people getting jobs, and those jobs will also be taxed. We will have better service provision, and this will improve our lives in Vihiga County. So in short, I would want to just put it briefly, that we want to trickle down the benefits of IT to our people. We will have increased computer literacy. We will facilitate and we will help facilitate the establishment of IT-related small businesses. We will increase online presence for our small businesses. We will create a pool of IT specialists for county development. We will improve the living standards of our people. And lastly, we will increase county revenue for Vihiga County. Thank you so much. Maybe if you have a question with it,
Wow, that, you guys, that is so amazing. I mean, you know, I'm listening to him talk and just looking at the opportunities Vihiga County can have, it's just humongous. If all our young people in Vihiga can just get employed. And you guys, I'm gonna go in Maragoli. I'm gonna talk in Maragoli because Mbora Mangana Gagena kam hulemule kabisa. Chigire sandara kuhulaitari kuhulamba. Kufana kuhulaitari kuhulada. Koreke ibindi bya kokora atimunda kwa hiskari. Na kuhiskari kwa kokora. This program that Nini Senator Vichi forward, Nzendora, iraku hiskari every day. You'll be able to employ yourself every day. Now let's make Vihiga County the information, you know, technology center in the whole of Kenya, in the whole of Africa. Chigirahe, one of it never give. And you know what? Not only are we talking about Vihiga County, I'm so for Bandu, Kakamega, and all that. That means we need to put up more satellites and the politicians. This is a challenge. Nena, Korore, how can we improve the lives of our people? Sasa, ola kuri nzi company langi nindi, most of my technology is handled actually in India. You know, it is handled in India. I would like this to be handled in Vihiga County.
True.
Willing to hire and subcontract because you know what, with information technology, this is so possible. We have many more topics to come through. So, asante sana, Senator. I wish Vanda wadige neka vahuli, Vanda vitu vahuli, vako hikura, because we need those brains. Manyi mune mwakushira muskuru kosoma, nikosoma. Sasa kwena kumuho, the wageri wakwasomera, and I don't know, we're gonna see. Nene ikuri randi ikura the senator kumtia endebe korore kure na kutransforma Vihiga County and I'm on board with that because
nene
andore wana vitu wakorandi ibava nizigas.
Niva advancer, yes.
Niva advancer. My happiness, wanakuri kukwawe kukera, kwe mutayame. My happiness is to see wana wakusuzwa wabe nizigas. Because they are desperate. Because we don't have to be desperate. Mm-hmm. We are geared, we have the power, we have the knowledge to really push Vihiga. If we can increase these companies in Vihiga County, kuratunga taxes to the county. So they can run the county government.
Yes.
It's a way bigger picture than you guys can imagine. So let's go ahead and get that going. I really appreciate you guys for coming in. Nim Kove live in Los Angeles. and he's in Washington, D.C. Technology. Yes. And that is the technology that we are talking about, that you don't have to be in the same building. Narakuba, Ibihiga, Namkori Ibindu, all over the world. And let me tell you, one of the benefits of the pandemic, it's exploded the information technology
to virtual.
It has exploded it. So if there was a side effect of the pandemic, this is the good side effect of it.
Yes.
Because technology has taken off in full swing. Just like, you know, when somebody invented the sliced bread, everybody started eating sliced bread. This is
Yes.
virtual jobs, virtual learning. You don't have to come to America. You can work for an American company without being in America.
Being in
Vihiga County, you can still do that. And that is the technology we want to bring to you guys. No.
And it's good. It's good you've used the example of the sliced bread. Yeah, IT is one big bread you can slice the way you want. Yeah.
Good night, everybody. Good day.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Asante sana, my people from Vihiga. I am here to serve you, and let me know what you want me to do, and I'll do it for you. I am coming to look for ways to help you. I'm not coming, unlike my opponents and competitors, I'm not coming to look for a job. I'm coming to look for opportunities for you and to make lives better, because I, like Judy has said before, I already work, I already have a job, but I want to sacrifice what I have right now to come and serve you. Thank you so much, my people.
Thank you.
Yes.